In the world of forensics, hair fiber analysis has a questionable past. Once a mainstay of criminal investigations, critics have argued that hair analysis is subjective, and experts have overstated its reliability. Forensic investigators still collect hair samples, but rarely use them anymore, instead relying on DNA. Glen Jackson and his team from West Virginia University are working on a hair analysis technique that will deliver details of the person's lifestyle that may be key in breaking a case. Using liquid chromatography in conjunction with isotope ratio mass spectrometry, the researchers measured the ratio of isotopes, atoms of the same element that have differing number of neutrons, found in keratin, the primary constituent of hair. This method is not difficult for a technician to perform, and therefore could become more common in crime labs. With the approach, the team identified 15 isotope ratio measurements that potentially could yield crucial information about certain lifestyle habits of individuals. To test this possibility, a researcher in Jackson's group collected hair samples from 20 women in Jordan. In a blind evaluation based on these hair samples, Jackson's team was able to predict the subject's body mass index with about 80% accuracy. Recently, the researchers conducted a similar study among 20 American men and women and found that they could identify the sex of a donor with 90% accuracy. While promising, Jackson says far more work needs to be done before this technique can be used in crime labs. For now, the analysis requires several strands of hair from the same person, which could make it difficult to use in forensic settings where only a single strand may be available. But if these kinks can be worked out, this technique could eventually be a complementary forensic tool to DNA analysis, filling in the gaps that genetic materials alone cannot plug. The researchers are presenting their work at the 253rd National Meeting and Exposition of the American Chemical Society. Headline Science is produced by the American Chemical Society. For more of the latest chemistry headlines, make sure to subscribe.